We seem to be made to suffer. It's our lot in life.
Hey everyone, and thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to do a double review for the Hot Toys versions of two of the most iconic characters in pop culture history, R2-D2 and C-3PO. The matte black box sleeves feature pictures of the lovable droids, and lifting them off reveals a see-through window of the figures and accessories. It's sort of styled like the classic Kenner packaging from the toys back in the day. Looks really nice. Up front, you can see the Attack of the Clones 20th anniversary logo, and on the side, there are photos and small character bios for R2-D2 and 3PO. Then on the back are a few different photos as well as Hot Toys-related information. The yellow tones in the artwork look great and really make these images pop. Sliding out the tray reveals a perfectly packaged product that immediately brings a smile to my face. For a small figure, this has so many cool accessories that my eyes really don't know where to look first. Just look at all these gadgets. And R2 feels great in hand. Super sturdy, not like the plastic we're used to. This is a premium product. I laid out all the accessories to make it easier to see, so now let's just go through them. First up is this amazing C-3PO portrait from that scene where he loses his head in episode 2. It feels solid in hand. Die-cast, plastic, but all perfect. Next up are these twin rocket thrusters that R2 never revealed in the original trilogy, yet they could have been kind of helpful. These can be attached to the sides of both of his legs and have that transparent blue blast effect. These two joint caps are also added to the rocket thrusters to give the illusion that it's extracting from the side. This piece represents the cable that R2 uses to drag C-3PO's head during the Battle of Geonosis. It has a small magnet on the tip that allows you to attach it to the head. R2-D2 is a figure that does not need a stand, but this plastic see-through stand is made to give him the illusion of flight when he fires off the rocket thrusters. Some batteries have been included for R2 as well as the remote, if you choose to use them. I'm not going to go through all of R2's gadgets individually, but I'll show you what's included. You're definitely getting your money's worth because there's a lot of stuff here. These small pieces are very fragile, so I advise extreme caution when handling them. Finally, there's the remote control that has the Star Wars logo branded on it. This is used to control R2-D2's light-up features as well as the sound effects. Here's the most badass droid in the galaxy, R2-D2. A bucket of bolts with extreme courage and loyalty who has saved his friends so many times. I have the sideshow version of this, but this Hot Toys version beats that one hands down. First of all, the dome is actually die-cast, and certain parts of R2's trim is metallic, allowing you to attach accessories magnetically. The level of detail is perfect with all the fixtures and wiring, and the third retractable leg, and the soiled weathering effects on his lower half let you know that this droid has covered a lot of ground. And if you choose to install the batteries, the dome easily pops on and off to reveal the battery slot. No issues at all. One of R2's gadgets can also be used to open up certain compartments on his shell via the magnetic tip. This makes it very easy to install R2's various gadgets and gizmos without breaking off your fingernails. There's also this one press and pop-up panel that allows you to reveal R2's scanner. R2's rocket thrusters can easily be attached by pulling off the molded clip. And then this is where you're going to attach those little caps. Put one on the left, one on the right. And after that, you can actually attach the thruster one on the left, one on the right. Pretty simple. And there you go. Now we have a flying R2-D2 who is ready for action. And this is how he looked when he's placed on a stand. It looks okay. I kind of wish they added a light-up feature for the flames. That would have really sold it better. I popped in all the batteries for R2 as well as the remote. On the remote, the R and W are the functions for the light and sound features. So let's see how that looks. All right, there we go. There's R2 lighting up there. Pretty cool. And this is a view from him from the back. And then let's hear how he sounds. C-3PO also has a light-up feature for his eyes. You just basically snap off the faceplate, add the batteries. There's a little switch inside that you click. Once that's lit up, you place the faceplate back on, and voila! C-3PO lit up. And here is R2 with every gadget attached to him, every port open, everything popped out, as well as C-3PO's head dragged from behind. And once again, please be careful when you add on all these pieces. They're very fragile and some of them are kind of sharp. But when you have it all together, it looks pretty cool. It's worth it. If you own previous versions of Hot Toys' R2-D2, you may not want this. I mean, if you're a completionist, I can understand, or you just want to have these added gadgets. But overall, it is a great figure for anybody who does not have it in its collection. It's a must-have. All right, and now we're on to Mr. Human-Cyborg Relations himself, C-3PO. Although other companies have done it, this is the first official Hot Toys release of a C-3PO figure. It's kind of odd that they started with Attack of the Clones, but hey, I'm just happy to have a C-3PO. Can I take this moment to please ask you all to like and subscribe? It really helps the channel out, and I want to get some more great content out to you. As you can see, C-3PO doesn't come with that many accessories, but let's take a look at what we have here. First up, we have a battle droid head for that one scene where C-3PO lost his head and had a little situation there. It's well done and has some decent articulation for some really nice head poses. Next up is a battle droid blaster rifle. I really like these guns, and there's a lot of cool detail on it. I especially like the little silver tabs there. Makes it look really nice when you photograph it. Besides the two hands that are already attached to C-3PO, it comes with four additional hands. You get two relaxed hands and two hands that are molded to hold the battle rifle. A lot of nice detail on these hands. I love the red metallic and also the black painted texture inside with the little grips. Really, really nice details. Batteries. Nothing else to say. And then there's the desert theme stand with the crouch grabber. We've seen the stand before with the molded footprints. It's okay. It's a stand. I want to admit up front that when I first heard the announcement from Hot Toys that they were releasing this figure, I was disappointed because I wanted the golden rod C-3PO that we all know and love. I didn't want one from Attack of the Clones. But then I saw this up close, and I immediately had to have it. This is definitely one of Hot Toys' best figures. If they gave out awards for best paint jobs and weathering, this figure would win by a mile. The level of detail on this figure, just the way it looks, you have to see it up close. I was completely blown away. It literally looks like a piece of rusted metal. And the details, like the painted wires in his torso and the brackets in his arm that slide up and down. And sure, the figure does not have a lot of articulation. You're not going to get a lot of movement out of it. But come on, you've seen the films. Did C-3PO look like he was very flexible? They did a really good job. They were very faithful to the original source material. And I know that R2-D2 also comes with the C-3PO head with the light up eyes, but when you see that head with the eyes lit up on C-3PO's body, that's the icing on the cake. Speaking of heads, you have the option of snapping off C-3PO's head and then replacing it with the battle droid so you can emulate that one scene in Attack of the Clones. I still plan to get the traditional golden C-3PO from Return of the Jedi when that comes out, but this figure is also going to have a place on my shelf. There's room for both of them because they offer two different looks and two different memories of C-3PO. I highly recommend this figure. Thank you, Hot Toys. You've helped me relive my childhood with the release of these two figures. I mean, this is the galaxy's dynamic duo right here. The adventures they've been on, the worlds they've seen, the battles they fought in. But even when planets were exploding around them, literally, they've always had each other. Yeah, they fight and bicker, but they are the best of friends. And they are part of the reason we love Star Wars so much. I'm going to close out this video with some posing shots I took. And I hope you all come back to the channel for future review videos. Please like and subscribe, and may the Force be with you.